I also see the fact that Keeper Dazzle is quite a strong lane. This is a lane.
Very bottom lane, paralyzing cast. They're going to go on Xiao Wei, Yoku. This could be the opening, the snowball protecting him, but they get a first blood in for Team Empire. Always want to fly the man to spill it. They waited for LGD to be slightly isolated, the paralyzing cast doing the work.
All time because he runs out of mana and then they can't make an aggressive play.
The snowball going in bottom lane, always on a fly, he's the man exposed. And they do find a revenge kill here, LGD moving with maybe.
They would have noticed that Resolution tried to TP and then he cancelled it, so Dragon Knight cannot help out Yoka right now.
Here comes your TP supporters, Wish Doctor coming back, but already actually cancelling the TP after Axe dies in the trees behind his tier 1 tower. But this is the punishment you look for.
Maybe find something bottom here, but like you said, the first part of the smoke didn't work, and it's going to be kind of obvious now with
Xiao Wei. He's in real trouble here. The Observer Ward saw him come up, so they'll go for the quick pickoff here on Xiao Wei. Storm going to jump in as well. Always want to fly. Trouble, not enough life to survive this initiation from maybe. And then they go down to Yoku as Yao jumps in, but Resolution, Dragon Form's already here to defend. Yao dropping low. Yoku just so tanky to breathe fire from Resolution, pushing back LGD. Maybe he's still got 10-1 charges. The Storm Spirit will survive, but the Dazzle, the Shallow Grave may allow him to get back out. The Ensnare. A low art dance controls him. MMY down for the count. The Culling Blade does the work. And that's where Axe is perfect up against the Dazzle.
Tower pressure Empire have made.
Bottom lane. They're coming down. Paralyzing cast because the initial stun. They go into the call, just controlling Yao. He'll be able to get the snowball off. Actually, no, he can't. Down for the count. Maybe he's going to jump in, dragging back Yoku. They're not close enough for the heal bomb and always want to fly. The Voodoo Restoration is doing some work. At the same time, Naga is about to loop in behind LGD to pick off the stragglers. Ensnare and Riptide's available. A low art dance. He goes after Xiao Wei, but a low art dance is isolated. They come on with a heal bomb. It's the PL Illusion doing some work. Xiao Wei, he can't TP out. Resolution's behind him. They're looking for more as we split the fight up. The last attack from the Dragon Knight will find that kill as Yoku, Team Empire, they're walking over LGD on the bottom lane. Silas in trouble. The Breathe Fire hitting Yao and the Song of the Siren. Aloha Dance of 58 life. They're regenerating up. There's no Paralyzing's cask, but they've got to stun Yao almost instantly. The call with the fire. Yao's going to drop. Yoku with the Culling Blade. The bonus is there, but now Storm Spirit. Maybe he's back in the fight after buying back Resolution. Get a TP. They all know there's your Vortex. Resolution dragged back in again. He doesn't have enough life to survive this. LGD will make the buyback worth it. Dazzle will find the kill. And we go 8-5 here in our first game of TI5.
That was still such a major win for Empire. I think even after the buyback, they come out something... What were they? If he wants to try to sit upward, he
They're
will.
About
They're
to
all
do
rotating
it.
In from above.
They need to control them. Storm Spirit, is there a way out of here? Resolution blinks forward. Look for that stun over on maybe. At the start of this one, they get it too. And the Sonic Wave! Maybe just explodes. MMY is snared up. But that Shallow Grave does not save you from Axe. Yoku on the chase. Blink Dagger. 3 seconds away, but Sylar just blinks himself down. Yao and Sylar, they get the stun over on that PL. He does have Doppelganger, and he'll jump. There's three of them. Which one's the real one? They call all the wrong ones. Sylar's gone west, and the blink up. You'll still be able to find him, but there's no control over on this PL until Battle Hunger will arrive. Resolution, there's your blink up. Into the Dragon Tower. Snowball will protect him for a moment. The spin hitting Sylar and Rohalo Hardes. Hit from the side with the Riptide. Always want to fly. He's on one life, and that PL will bring him down, but Xiao Wei is stared up. Resolution wants to keep going. Yoku helping him out, and they're right on the back of Yao. LGD, they're being pressured by the Russians. Yao still ticking down that Shadow Strike and Battle Hunger. They're trying to keep him up. The shards can't control Yoku, but he's going to snowball into Sun, bringing him up. They can't get him up on the high ground. Not just up there, but Yao's at least able to survive. Storm Spirit back into the mix. Silent, blink to the tree lines. Buys a second Oblivion Staff. He doesn't know. The Storm Spirit jumps down, chasing up for a low hard dance, but the bigger man, Silent, might be able to escape from this. Needs to cast, but in comes the snowball. Sylar and maybe being controlled. The blink did work, at least for Queen of Pain. Unfortunately, Witch Doctor does not possess the same ability. He will be dying on this bottom lane. He'll make him work for it, but LGD will get at least a return kill. But again, Xiao Wei, the captain of LGD, has to run, but Resolution caught in the tree line, trying to fight his way out of here, but he's locked and being mana leaked in, and Sylar, well, he has to come and help. Xiao Wei, no TP scroll, so he's forced to stand here while the snowball coming in. Sylar will blink up and away from the snowball's Husker, catching him out in the tree line. One further down, the Witch Doctor goes to work. They bring down that PL. That's one way to stop his farm. The T1 tower, one attack from Resolution will take it out, but instead he wants the kills. The blink forward, they look for the call, the double one as well. Yao is so low, and there's Yao. Dunk coming in from Yoku. They need to protect Resolution though. He's so low in the paralyzing cast plus Restoration doing his work. There's another blink in 1 second, but the Sonic Wave, that will take out MMY. A 4-0 trade-off, including a tier 1 tower, and now damage to the tier 2.
this is not just damage. This tower is definitely gone. Resolution, finally now his double damage rune expires, but this tower is not long for life. They have no way of holding it. They're responding in 5 seconds, and then the tower is pretty much gone, so...
What's going wrong with the fights for LGD? How is Empire getting the upper hand every time?
It's just difficult for...
Delete into the tower, he blinks forward, going up to Xiao Wei. The Breathe Fire even goes up to MMY, and there's a gem forward! And the Sonic Wave from Silent! LGD is so low, they're being taken out inside their own base! Silent looking forward in the cover of the BKB, but he's not taking too much damage from the tier 4 towers! They went too deep, they have not taken the objective, and now LGD with a buyback by Tusker, snowballing forward, always gonna fly up in the air! There's that song of the siren, it's not coming yet, there it is! Now Team Empire can back themselves out. There's enough mana for Maybe to jump to, and Aloha Dance almost accepting fate here as he lets his teammates jump out. There's no TP scroll on the Naga. He's down for the count. And Team Empire, is that the biggest mistake they've made so far?
Yes. And this is what's dangerous.
Roshan, 700, 600, Song of the Siren. It's going to isolate it, but Storm Spirit still jumps in. DK is the Aegis to the Immortal. Maybe right in the middle of Team Empire. Stunned up, Shiva's Guard, Chella Great. Doesn't protect again. Empire's got Aegis and a kill. MMY's on the run out of here. They might have got the shards to lock him in, but Star's still doing the work all by himself. Resolution will blink up after him too. But LGD, they take the T1 tower, the blink up already from Resolution. They catch out Yao with the Orchid, and you do have that Shallow Grave. They need Yao a little bit lower, so now they can go for the dunk. They also give Team Empire the buff up. Remember, objective-based gaming, they've got to keep going on these buildings and get themselves racked advantage here against Slip Push lineup with the PL Illusion ripping apart Sun, but number four, dead. We already see Resolution getting in there. Cold down, but maybe looking for the kill on Sun. The blink away, not going to be successful, but they're still fighting with the Death Ward. MMY barely surviving back past the Tier 4 towers as Empire, they still try and fight LGD under the tier 3 tower. They've lost two and, well, basically lost most of their mana, especially when you can get that mana drain on Resolution. The extra stun, Sala to the front line, Diffuser Blink, it's still going to trigger Aegis Immortal, but maybe the 10 second BKB, that's why he's isolated Resolution. He needs more time and he wasn't born. Yoki thinking about jumping back in again, and a Jowl Wait to actually bring down the Dragon Knight, and they look for more. Maybe jumping deep after Aloha Dance, they keep with the remnants, they're slowing him down, but that's a very tanky
such a good team to run them down. Ice Shard, Snowball, Sigil.
Oh, wait a second. Okay. The double claw goes for Yao, the Sonic Wave from Sun. Perfectly on target. The PL, however, brought down the Witch on the back lines, but Yoku, he's going on an absolute charge. MMY slow. Sun chasing him down the control. Silent with a call. There is still that burst heal. Maybe jumping in. Low on mana, but Yoki's got nothing. He's bone dry right now. Trying to retreat, but they bring down the axe. Sun has to blink himself away from the PL.
And to rest of Team Empire, they're missing on the map. And again, LGD's map awareness, absolutely perfect.
Well,
they're noticing they're moving
out. Into them right now.
They could. Yao's actually moving down. And here they come. The jump up. This will be a solid pick off on the Tusker. But they still commit a heavy smoke for it.
Yeah, the problem there, Vampire, is there's no collateral. We focus on that a lot. When you get a good gank or a good fight, you want to take towers. And of course, that's what we've seen from LGD a couple of times. They get a little bit of a lead in the fight.
Down to the bottom lane, looking at Sila, but this could be the worst kill to try and go for. They jump up, they've got the vision, the sentry wall was there. Sila's gonna drop. LGD, they were looking for a pickoff and they got it.
And guess who got the kill?
Looks like Team Empire's going to try and make LGD blind on the map. They're bringing a gem down to Aloha Dance now. Storm Spirit actually jumping in. Where's these BKBs? Resolution gets it off with the perfect call. Yao's down low. They need to bring him down all the way and they cannot do it. The Sonic Wave from Silent. Minimal effectiveness. Yao dropping low to Resolution. He's just sitting up there. Maybe jumps in. They Song of the Siren. It's one for one trade-off. They're looking for
LGD.
More.
Storm Spirit jumping in again. This time it's always going to fly the Witch Doctor. But Axe jumping in with the Sonic Wave. The perfect call. The Snowball protecting him to the now the Tusk gotta join him. Empire haven't lost anything. They keep fighting Sun outside the base, but Sila ripping him apart. Sila just cannot repel power like that. He's just not tanky enough. Too far up, they're gonna hex on him. This DK way too far up, but maybe they have enough damage. Resolution's dropping low, and he's down for the count. The rest of Empire couldn't get there in time.
He does have buyback.
They will, under the cover of the sigil, maybe gets his BKB off. They jump in deeper, maybe dropping low. Where's the damage? Yoku back in again, but he's too low. The spins are doing some work, but it's just not enough. Yoku's down. They snowball in deep under the tier 4 towers. Nowhere Yao wants to be, but he blinks himself back to to exactly where he wants to be, outside the base, letting the PL Illusions do the damage to the tower. They might get an there on Xiao Wei, but he's happy to stick around. Yoku bought back these PL Illusions. Empire just have no mana to work with. They have no stamina in these fights where the PL keeps draining them out, taking away these blink daggers. Silent again, forced to blink all the way back to well, while Syla is this raid boss sitting on the front lines. He doppelgangers away as Yoku trying to jump him. Now Yoku's gonna go down. There's a pit call. The damage, the sonic wave. They're just pushing him in. There was enough spins, but actually, no, there's not. There's just too much on Syla. He is gonna win this game hands down by himself. Silent, the only one he thinks he can kill is the old man keeper of the light. A blink away down towards the mid lane, but they just keep getting healed up. Illuminate after Illuminate, bringing LGD back to 100%. And Syla once again moves forward to win it for LGD. He's doing it solo. And LGD,
I don't think they're done.
They just take the full megas. There is no reason to back up, always gonna fly, dead to the world. He got burned from the illusion to start with, and then Snowball over on two, Silent being dragged back, Resolution as well, battling. They are farming Team Empire, practically on the edge of the well. There is only one remaining, and there it is, it's just GG. LGD take game one against Team Empire, repairing a 15k gold deficit to hit back with a very farmed up PL and a great game plan from LGD.
Do you think they could switch up the lanes as well, like put the Quap on the safe lane and put Anti-Mage mid against Storm?
They could, but it's going to be a tough matchup for him, I think, especially with the Hall. It's going to be very hard to go for the last hits.
From
Snowball down, they're going for a low heart dance, it's going to be the first blood, a low heart dance, there it is! And almost not. Sans the front lines, Yao, ready to snowball in, but always going to fly. Starts both the ulti and the wall, and they're going to snowball underneath the tower. Resolution! There's your big sonic wave, returning into LGD, punching the mana void, doing very, very little, but at the same time, blinking down further, Silent, too aggressive, back into the fight. It's going to be LGD getting the revenge kill, and what a big one as well, it's the Anti-Mage.
I feel like it's unusual for Tusk's level 7 to do this. The second level in Snowball is great for laning.
Could be in trouble right now. That's going to be enough damage. A resolution double damage rune. That's where the extra bit came from. So they get rid of these Lycan Morbs as quick as they can. Anyway, just going to blink into the trees. Probably wants to get away. Storm Spirit jumps in, gets the dust. Maybe there's enough mana left here with stick charges to ensure the kill on the Bounty Hunter.
Health. After that.
Resolution now. They've actually got Xiao Wei and MMY. This could be an easy double kill for him. They just need to burn the mana, and now Xiao Wei, he's low. They all set the rope, but the sonic wave completely blown. The shockwave comes up to ensure the kill. That's actually Yoku's blink dagger right there, and they will get MMY. This time they have to wait because there's no Cunning Blade, and Yoku, not a healthy man, but he does pick up the blink dagger and a skewer to TP away to safety.
Empire look a bit nervous from that play.
Always when it flies in the neighborhood, and that is your health. That's a big disruptor, and he sees Yao just going to skewer him up, and now, well, Snowball, but the wall's already there, and Yao, there's nowhere to run away. If Storm Spirit wants to jump in, well, actually, they just jump over to Roshan. Yao is currently going to get glimpsed back up again. Resolution is here, so Yao will die, but Roshan's already been taken out by LGD.
Yoku has gone for...
Oh, Aloha.
Oh, wait a second.
Easy jump.
He is.
Dust him, and they bring him down.
It's a kill. So, the Magnus this game surprised Yoku went for this skill build. Usually when you're playing with a melee carry in competitive Dota, you like to get more emphasis on empower and a little bit less on skewer. So you go like 4-3-2-1 build when you're level 10. His impact in the next 10 minutes, the problem for Magnus is the time it takes for him to get high level empower now is really long because of how long level 11 is. As this is going to be another easy kill. They have to be looking at their lineup and be like, oh, they have to be looking at their lineup and be like, our bounty hunter's dead again.
They're snowballing after him at the moment. An Aloha dance. It was just on the edge of the range of dust. TP out, Vortex, he's in range for it. Yoku's gonna be controlled. No blink dagger for him. He actually binds up the staff of wizardry, accepting his fate of death. The shards are coming in too.
He used that very well there. Now Aloha dance. Not again.
That's number 5. They need detection, however. They don't have it. They're just trying to do it with AoE. And actually, he walked in range of the sentry ward on the hillside. Storm Spirit jumping on the Quap to drop their ulti. They're trying to control the Storm Spirit. And where's Quap? Can't blink away in time. Sun already did it himself, but these Negrius are chasing up the Storm Spirit. It's only the Aegis. The more they might pop here. That's going to be all. There's not a lot left in the tank. And in fact, with Bounty under here, AM needs time. And well, RP, they hold maybe in position. The Mana Void will take him out. Trying to run away, but there's just too much damage from the big wolf. They chase after a low heart dance as well. Into the tree, storm up, and they get the kill. Team Empire get a sentry. Storm Spirit jumps in. Yao, very quickly on the way in, but a low heart dance. stays alive. They're going to glimpse attempted Yao back, but he moves so quickly. Now Storm can go in again. They just jump over top of a low item. Still no detection. Now it's going to be there, but Skewer back. Maybe he's out of mana. There's nothing more to give, but they've already taken out the Disruptor here, LGD. As Empire move into the Radiant Jungle, Roshan is alive and fighting.
I know I'm talking about the Empower a lot, but it makes a really big difference for Silent to get that extra 30% damage and cleave.
Yep.
Now, unfortunately, Aloha Dance.
Actually keeping the rest of Empire at bay. The jumps up, always on a fly, Laguna Blade. They bring down the Disruptor, so there's no storm.
Wait for the jump. There it is over an Aloha Dance. The Weasels are going to go to work, and Aloha Dance. Wow, that's not a great time for him.
But a Mana Void tearing apart the storm. Remember, there's the Aegis Immortal, the gems over on the deck. MMYB had to grab it. They're snowballing in. In fact, maybe back to World of Living. Straight after Yoku. Still no RP. Where are these buybacks that don't exist for Team Empire? But the Animage is able to find a couple of kills. Silent trying to run out of here. Resolution staying on the tail. How long will that survival last? And it's going to be long enough. Silas back to base. They find him in white. Yule Scepter cancelling that TPR. Maybe still in the neighborhood, but he knows he can't do anything. The gem is lost for LGD. A triple.
Oh, wait a second. He showed himself in mid. This opens up bottom lane for LGD.
They dive in deep and they just keep going. The snowball. A can disruptor. A heavy commitment. Maybe he's down to a lower percentage of his mana pool, but they find it opening a resolution. Orkin, and he self-fuels it to try and get out. Now in comes Silas. Focusing on MMY, he's out of the fight for now, but he's lost two of his teammates. They've been out of the Mana Void, ripping apart the Lina over towards Yahoo's also drive for the blink up. Maybe he jumps in again, but Aloha Dance keeping the Shuritosses flying. Maybe he's on the run out. He needs to get the mana low, and Silent's gonna do so. Like it, back to the fight. Silent turns over now on Sylar. He needs more help, and then maybe Beast up. There's your Shuritosses coming out. Animage finds one, and the cleave is a double kill. It keeps going. Silent, madly. There is a mana void available. He needs to burn all mana. Yule Scepter off at Animage. He's still got 1700 life. They're working through it. Now Yao's back, punching him up. Silent, get out of town. He's down for the count. Star 13 is chopped out by maybe finding a Aloha Dance with the Orkin. They're going to catch out too. They might have survived, but Empire just gave so much back to LGD.
Shall we?
In fact, Sorcerer jumped to the side. They took out Disruptor, but the Yule Scepter from Shall We is delaying so much. The final track did come in. The Silas at the front lines. How much damage? He's still chasing after a low hard dance. The Sonic Wave. Silas dropping so low. He doesn't have much more to give until the Shadow Grave will keep him up. Maybe isolating Yoku. He doesn't even get the RP off once again. Silas diving so deep. It's actually Resolution. The finally cut finds that kill over on Silas. But where is his Animage going? Chasing after Yao. The track is up again. The mini stuns. Yao so low. He's waiting on the Mana Void. Realizing the Shadow Grave is coming back in again from Dazzle. And maybe a TP out with that ball lining going to work. Yao, they still see him with the track. The only thing they can do is try and disable him, but they're using Silent as the punchy bag, and he just jumps in! Destroys the Dazzle! No Shadow Grip, but maybe! Looking for revenge and always want to fly! An ulti, can he get something off? He actually can! Splitting up this engagement! Sylar, he does chase down, but again, so much commitment for the Disruptor!
Before Lina and Tusk respawn.
What so Sylar is meant to do? His Stormbird jumping in! Yoku, your time, man! It is your time for ultimate! They get rid of the wolves! The melee rex is going Yoku. He's silenced up again. He can't do anything with maybe a pistol blade. And there's your Soul Spirit going down. That's Team Empire find the combo. Sylar to the front lines, beating into Resolution, going for Aloha. But now Sylar losing his mana, losing his life, forced back again. It's still a double raxing Empire. They're going up to MMY. Is this the death push? They're moving up. They need the tier 3 towers. The fight for Megas is real for Empire. They're so close to forcing a third game. No mistakes.
Yeah, backdoor regen is going to kick in and they will give up on getting the third lane. So LGD managed to buy themselves some time there, sacrificing a storm, sacrificing a dazzle. And they still lose two lanes of racks, and now it's just...
The courier's delivering in the gem at the moment, and they actually attack the courier with the wolves. This might flag the fact that Empire, they're behind him, and maybe the jump off the abyssal plane. They control him in the RP! Catching out two with the Sonic Wave, the snowball! Protect him long enough! Maybe down jump himself away! Yoki's trying to chase after the kill, and then even glimpsing him back. Silent down for the count. This could be it. Yao's on the run back. You have your buyback coming in from the Lycan, but he's losing his teammate so quickly, and Animage carving him apart. GG! Team Empire will take game number two here, up against the clear favorites for this matchup with an ultra kill for Silent. The Russians have hope here.
I feel it's always so risky to Like, it's so hard to pick the mid laner right now because you're facing mid plus bounty. It's always quite hard to come up with a mid laner that can actually deal with that. And last game they went for Lycan mid, which was very, very smart because the Lycan can always farm jungle. He doesn't care so much about the bounty.
And the way LGD are laning this time around with an aggressive dual lane here with Rubick and Gyro, as well as the roaming bounty hunter, they were definitely looking
to light strike into the shards of maybe. He's a good turnaround for the Searing Chains. Yaoi's here, trying to be into resolution. He didn't see him. Another light strike, a race back up cooldown. But the slide of fist from maybe will find that kill. The TP in from the Dazzle was actually cancelled, and they let Aloha Dance die.
They're diving out. That's the highest win rate.
They're diving in. Just shards up and lock him in position. They're waiting a little bit for the cogs. And now the snowball picking up the PL on the way through. And this will be one very dead clockwork. Nice chaining of combos there from Empire to ensure the longest duration of control on that clock.
186. Not bad.
It's worth a decent amount. Middle lane, resolution. Missing the light strike array, and again LGD. They're looking for the kills, diving in deep under the tower. Maybe with that DD rune has enough damage to finish the job. And again, another TP burned here by Always Wanna Fly. Unable to get there in time for the Shallow Grave. Also had no mana once he arrived, hence he cancelled it this time. He didn't have the Shallow Grave last time he attempted the TP.
A slight bit by resolution just on raw CS, but of course he will have the clear net worth advantage on the three kills.
It's 2.6k to 1.0.
Aloha Dance is very dead.
Yeah.
They're just gonna dive him.
They rocket down to have a look at him. He's making a play for the TP scroll.
He doesn't have mana, he's totally dead.
Yeah. In fact, he buys the TP scroll before he even reaches the side shop. And the Shuriken toss available as well, so he's making him waste as much time as possible. And there's the death of Yoku. Are they going to give it to Sylar? Yeah, no. The Rubick will be greedy. He'll take it for the boots. But he's back too deep behind the tower. So Sylar just creeps Gibson, so now they can jump in. But, yep, Ember Spirit, they're going on resolution, and he actually manages to dodge again the Fighter Fist. No support can arrive in time, and now it's Yoku. Not in the greatest position of his life either.
Well, they still have decent CS on the PL, so that one against Jaro is an even trade-off.
Call down, has to snowball, and then runs himself out of it. Shards up, and with the Light Strike Array, they get a shorter kill on Sylar. You lose your Tuskar for it, but you finally get some level of comeback in for resolution.
PL is a special carry, though, in the sense that he can
resolution.
Actually...
Oh, boy. They'll pick him up, they'll follow up with Yao. Actually gonna hookshot at point-blank range. They do find the kill over on resolution. But Sylar's still forcing out the tier 1 tower in the bot lane, and is this almost getting to a point where you're killing resolution so much that you're not even sending him backwards? He's just at a standstill. Your PL farming up is creating space. Like Yao, he's moving over for Sylar, who actually knows he can take a fair amount off Yao. But Xiaowei down here as well, going for a low hard dance. He needs to snowball quickly, couldn't get it off in time. Yao put the perfect cog position out, and they'll track up over on Sylar. So LGD moving as four heroes while it's actually Yoku, the man they're creating space for, but they go deeper. Sylar doppelgangering away. They're going to find him before the TP, and they do. They stop his TP out. Sylar, a little bit of damage into Yao, but they got another one. Yeah. It's Always Wanna Fly. Track him up, throw him down, and then, he will keep himself alive a little bit longer with a Shallow Grave. Resolution's coming in too. That lands over on Yao. The Light Strike Array, they can ensure the kill over on Yao. So it does become a trade-off, but this is still a bounty kill for LGD. Protect Resolution. Slide of Fist, he didn't get the Searing Chain, so another Spirit has to be committed, and they still finally get that kill. A hefty commitment. They're chasing after MMY with the Lancers up, but a call down from Sylar. The RP will lock him in position. One charge for Sylar, being ripped apart again. Maybe they can keep him alive with a doppelganger away, but he's locked inside the tree line. Three heroes down, LGD ripping apart Empire. Not to mention MMY got away with RP, so he'll have that for the next fight. Well, maybe Searing Chain or Lowar Dance. The snowball's there. He can walk back to his tier 2 tower. Again, these one charges helping out a little bit, but not enough. LGD, a 4-0 trade, and the snowball is real for China.
So that flame guard stays up. It can be purged.
They're going to get that pickup and Always Wanna Fly. The track was giving him the movement speed, LGD. Triggers the regen and ready to fight again. At the same time, Hookshot finds a low hard dance. Tuskar, cog push back into the Telekinesis. They can throw him almost back into the cogs, but instead they throw him into the open arms of Sylar. And that kind of mana burn will help out LGD. And there's that And there's that Blink Dagger up. They're going to lose Always Wanna Fly. He'll Shallow Grave, potentially could TP Yao, but with Yao right next to him, he knows that, with the battery salt, there's no way he's surviving that. You'd expect it around this point for him. While Sylar's already on his way to his damage dealing item. And they are giving space to resolution. This really doesn't feel
he just revealed himself.
Doppelganger. Gotta block him with the illusions. Hookshot actually goes over to Yoku, completely bypassing Sarp, but actually isolates Yao. He'll turn on the blade mail and move himself away. Another doppelganger to avoid the shuriken toss, but always want to fly. Picked up, thrown down, and the side of fist to ensure the kill just as the Shadow Grave wears off.
Might be a prophet right here.
He's a long way up.
Oh, he doesn't even have a TP. He's in a horrible position here. Yep.
He's going to have to doppelganger away. They pick him up, throw
he's
him down.
Yeah.
Oh, this is the hook shot. Oh, and a cooldown will come in, but he is just trapped inside the cogs. And that's the situation I was talking about, where you just have that moment.
They might be able to force buyback here if they go for it. They still have the Aegis on Gyro.
Yep.
It's 50 seconds.
They're chasing after Always Wanna Fly. These two Observer Wards for the Dire Side are on the opposite sides of that Observer. The Radiant, and there's your hookshot from Yao. They split Zhao Wei and MMY, so he was capable of coming in for that hookshot, cancelling the TP out, and then they'll instantly deward the Vision.
It's actually a pretty good spell steal, too.
Doppelganger up, the Yulsa Forever on the Bounty Hunter, can't control, hookshot down from Yao, pushing him back, but the Skewer dragging him closer, the Lancer's still going to chase after Yao, they're back in base, side of fist searing chase, Magnus is low to call down, it's going to find the kill! Magnus down for the count, but buyback is available, LGD. He's just got a land spam, keeping Yao low, but they jump in. There's your Searing Chain again. MMY, not a healthy man with those illusions following. It's Lina. Yule set her up. Scylla, actually going to Shallow Grave over on Resolution so he can jump in. Lacuna Blades on Scylla. Resolution! Two life! He gets back to base, but no, he doesn't! He burns to the attack of the Gyrocopter of all people.
Oh, look at the Ember just keeping them at bay like that. Just one crit sends two heroes back to the fountain.
So it's a five-man smoke move to ramp all the way around. And Aloha Dance is the man to die. Quite fast as well.
He does a buyback though. I think this is actually the best thing that could have happened for Empire, apart from not losing any heroes, was for him to go out there, scout the smoke, and just be a casualty.
Not expecting us to try and go against this, but then again, LGD, they smoke up and move over. They're very close, and Empire, they smoke, but instantly Yao's gonna break it. The Lance in, but Yao going all the way after Aloha Dance, and maybe with a snowball, Yao's in, beaten down by Resolution, down for the count, but maybe chasing after Resolution, but Resolution's already thrown out everything he really needs to do, while PL, well actually, where is his attack? He cannot do it. Maybe chasing right behind him. Sun's got a lot of light behind him, including 17-1 charges. He's taken all the mana off Zhao Wei, and it's a two-for-one situation. Trade-off, that is. So they'll see Zhao Wei,
a Yule
Scepter to start with. And now, where's the follow-up? Can it be quick? And here it is. Bounty Hunter will drop, they'll deward out. Ember Spirit jumping forward, and back shot. Long way in, four stops away straight away, though. Was forced to get a reaction out from Team Empire. The side of Fitz with a blink forward! Man, they drop so quickly! They're burning so hard! Sarn, however, man-moding up against Sarn, the BKB. He has to doppelganger away from this one. He'll leave a couple of himself with another hookshot in from Yao. Sarn forced off back from the cogs. He will go down. No buyback available right now for Sarn. And this could be it for LGD. They got Empire licking their wounds in base. They will take the bottom racks, but it's 70. They
are that crippled. Slide of fist flat cannon combo almost killed three heroes.
Here they go again. Resolution controlled. Hook shot after it. Yao going to work. Yoki, he actually can't get himself out this one. He's locked here forever, and even critting down the back lines of the Dazzle. The only one up is buyback is Lina, and that's it. GG! LGD will advance themselves forward to the semi-finals, knocking Team Empire into the lower bracket.
Yeah, Shiki has played that mid before.
So it is a mid Lina.
Winter Wyvern. Winter Wyvern picked for the 30th time with a...
These are the next level strats that we expect from Cloud9.
He's gonna get it!
One more shot, and down it goes! Boat 7, suicide in the enemy Thalion, he'll spend his gold. Knowing Cloud9, we expect something different from this team. You go back to the International 4.
...is for control. So the game fairly slow so far. Normally at this point, C-Deck are diving towers and going for multiple kills, but the ward has disappeared in this bottom lane. Gyrocopter is now level 6. Cloud9 really have to be careful here. Calldown could come aggressive. Looks like he wants to go for this one. There's the calldown. Should connect on Misery. Can he get the self-deny? Nope, no chance. Tries for the brain sap. But first blood will go to C-Deck. In the end, this is...
the stacks and look for the pickoffs if they can.
They want mid.
They know
they
want mid.
They see Bone 7. The stun's gonna come through. They follow it up with the Laguna Blade. He barely gets it up. Then the hook is gonna prevent a counter initiation from Misery. And now Q joins the fray. Cheeky kept alive for now. Not quite low enough. Misery, self-sleep. Is it gonna be sufficient? Here's the call down. The backstab from Aggressive rushing in on Defana.
Turtle Envy. He's up to 100 stolen damage, but he can't deal with the magic punishment of Aggressive. The man from behind finds a couple. Make it 5-1 as Cedic continue to press in, but a well-placed sprout by Bone7. He's not all that tanky yet. He doesn't actually have the mech complete. He's got a lot of armor.
Oh,
but that may not
help
him. This hook connects, and it will. It's a bullseye. Eternal Envy trapped within the cogs. No relocate available yet, and they blast him away. Cheeky strikes again, and they look for more. Misery trapped in the woods, trying to retreat out. Call downs at the ready, but Cloud9 a bit too close to that tier 2 tower. So C-Deck fail. XE looking for the initiation here. Big Daddy off on the trees. Rocket's going to come through. They get eyes on him, and they hook him in immediately. Battery's off, and there's the track. That's a four-hero track takedown, and now the call down on two. What a winter's curse from Q! Demolishes two more. C-Deck rampaging through the Cloud9 side of the map. So how do you, what's your play beyond that? You mentioned they don't really have initiation. Do you want to see like a Blink Dagger on Dragonite? We've seen this from Empire's Garter. We'll get caught off in the Radiant Woods and finished off, but I mean, what's the solution to that particular problem? You can find a good fight.
I think it was...
Well, they're relocating. Oh. Here they go. Onto the bottom lane. Aggressive trapped out to start the fight. Now the static blade coming through, but he runs, and now he's going to turn with the call down again, the Winter's Curse, and they're running into it with Eternal Envy. He does have the mech. He retreats out for now. Aggressive hiding in the trees as the hook comes through. XE tries to hold Thana in place. They do have the track on him, but he's a rather tanky fellow, and I don't think they quite have the firepower to bring him down. Instead, they look for Misery. Already used the brain set. Laguna to end him, getting a little bit outflanked here. C-Deck, again, the ones finding the kills.
I think C-Deck, once they get items like the Aghanim Scepter and the level 1601 at top, Misery's gonna get initiated on as Bone7 comes in, but Misery is a long way from the rest of his team, but everybody's rotating over now.
Here they go, Aggressive trying to finish off Misery. They don't get the track kill. He's healed up by the mech of Eternal Envy, and now the chase is on. Look for the
relocate.
The relocate's gonna bring them even farther forward. The Winter's Curse goes onto Eternal Envy, who tags Laguna. He's already used the mech. He gets splatted onto the ground, blown up by the forces of C-Deck. They even managed to keep Aggressive alive, and now they look for more. The Yule Scepter thrown out as Big Daddy will relocate back to where he once came from, and they're waiting for him. They're just laying into C9 and collecting kill after kill after kill. There just doesn't seem to be a silver lining this game.
Levels between the two of them? And
they just don't feel safe. They just don't feel like they can get active.
Oh, they're going to run into Fada.
They are going to make their move now. There's a fight breaking out of the Radiant Jungle where Aggressive gets Fiend's Grip, but the hook's going to cancel. Well played by XE as Aggressive marches back, but he's trapped inside of this ground. This will be a gigantic kill, and they're sapping all the damage. Eternal Envy looking for vengeance here. Will he be able to finish him off? Aggressive does fall. It's three wiped out for C-Deck all of a sudden. Gigantic fight going their way. Garter wanted to catch the Big Daddy IO right before the relocate ends there.
But you can't press into that, especially against a team like C9. It just feels like they have some sort of magic.
Oh, Cheeky wants Big Daddy. He's got vision right now from the rocket. No, he's going into the pit, trying to fight this one out, but the Aegis will go onto Eternal Envy as they look for an organized retreat. Cheeky still nuking them on the way out. XE able to snipe Big Daddy there. The hook shot wasn't even required. Laguna onto Misery, also on the run. The hook actually goes to the north where Fada gets trapped. Three hero track takedown. Immediately, Bone7 heads top. He wants to split push this and slow it down, and they're not done just yet. Misery still being pursued. Cheeky gets slept, and it seems Misery may live to fight another day.
They do. The Dragon Knight absolutely needed the BKB, and the smoke is picked up on the Wisp now, and I think this is the timing. You've got a BKB.
Oh, you might not be the timing. They're going to find the Nature's Prophet here. Big Daddy has the defensive relocate. Will it even come out in time? Not even going to try for it. Just a quick TP wave, but no! Big Daddy is denied by XE, and Cheeky cleans him up, and now Eternal Envy.
Oh, he's in no man's land.
Teammate died twice here. He's stealing all of Garter's damage. He's painting himself out. They have no buybacks in either global hero. He's now diving towards the enemy well, just stalling this and running from a pack of angry wolves, but they'll kill him up once. They've got the track potentially ready to come out again. Garter sets up. They've got cogs in position. Eternal Envy, no static link. It's going to be the death of him once more. Aegis caved in. C-Deck not even giving up a single objective to that Aegis. Call down. Cheeky does have the Yule Scepter, and that's going to force out the BKB. No way to kill him off now, but that's his 10-second BKB charge immediately used.
Oh, and at top, Bone7's getting initiated on.
Beautiful pick. Q with the solo kill, it looks like.
There's not really one item that's going to change their fortune anymore.
It's just not really C9 Dota to play that way. Like, if you told me LG... Oh, here's the hook on again and again. It's been XE finding out Big Daddy. He can't even try for the tether away. It'll get instantly interrupted. And now Cheeky with the monster kill picking off the Bane of Misery. Will be delayed here for 3 minutes. This Bone 7 TP's out, but no! XZ again with the hooks, just butchering Bone 7. He's caught on the periphery of the cooldown, and again he falls.
He does get the courier, and he is slowing down the game, and it's really what they need to do, but man, it still costs them. As Eternal Envy moves up. He's tracked up right now. They have a Winter's Curse available. He's hunting forward. They've relocated Fada in. They get eyes on the Guarder with the dust going through. He mechs himself. He tries to run a bit further, but he can't make it out. Eternal Envy getting something out of this. The relocate now done. And Envy on the run. He doesn't have a TP. Oh, Envy, you need your TP quickly, my friend. He's going to go for it. Do they have a way to cancel this? No hookshot available. The Yules, oh, they got him with the stun. No TP, no way out. Down again. Not the first time that's happened to Cloud9, but man, it really
they have
hurts.
One smoke on them available.
Bone 7 in the top lane. He's been caught out by Aggressive. Caught out's going to come through. The Sprout, not going to be good enough. He's dead to the Rocket Barrage. Punishing every Cloud9 movement. They might even go for Eternal Envy top. That'd be a bit too far to go.
Winter Wyvern get one by himself.
They're going in. They're going in once more. Here's the track. The follow-up stun comes through Misery. No chance for a brain set. They didn't even need the
Probably
Laguna.
The biggest game that comes to mind is the aggressive Slordar game, where Vici tried to rat it out with the Tiny Wisp, and it was just punished at every turn.
But now we go again for C-Deck. Over and over, diving in. The BKB deployed. And aggressive reigning supreme with Sheiky just doing all the damage in the world. He's still got a Laguna Blade. He can basically pop Bone 7 instantly, but he's holding the ultimate. Looking for Misery, pow, right in the kiss up, and then the Bloodstone deny as the Laguna goes out. Even that one kill denied to Cloud9. They are being given nothing here for free. Q may get caught. Nope, doesn't seem like it's the case. Effect, it's Eternal Enemy in danger. There's no relocate. The Wisp is dead. He's trapped. He's down. Fada next. C-Deck just rampaging forward, and it's GG. A team that didn't even have a guaranteed slot at the main has just taken the first match here off of Cloud9. Wildcard team, no longer. This team has a shot at going deep if they can keep it up.
Against a PL Witch Doctor, yeah, okay.
Zeus.
Zeus.
Oh, this is another hero Fada plays brilliantly.
That's a very good approach to the Lina Bonnie. Just spam out the lane. Lina
but if he gets a good ult, Zeus ult comes over the top, so too the Scarlet Mage in a lot of trouble. As they look to dive XC, Cloud9 off to a much better start already. Give them the first blood. It's the Io Skywrath duo. They have options this game. They don't have to all in as mid lane. Misery will get blown up by Sheiky. It's only a support Skywrath, but that is going to slow down the offense here.
I believe the first of the game, plus 10 damage. Eternal Envy getting involved with that one as well. He'll be the one to collect the gold. And Eternal Envy now rotating towards the bottom side of the map. He's going to run right past Garter. He doesn't have any backup. He's playing awful aggressively, and this could get punished here potentially. There's a tier one available, and out comes the Lance, and Envy's caught, and the Death Ward comes splashing through. He's going to get a call down off of three, but they've already brought him down. That's going to be a track gold going their way. Garter going in biz, Dust getting popped, and aggressive going back in. This is the kind of scrappy fight that C-Deck loved to go for. Big Daddy almost finished off. He's able to completely deny the Bounty Hunter here on his way out, but there's still a little bit of a chase going on with the Phantom Lance and Regressive diving back towards the Tier 2 tower. He will get the kill. It's 4 C9 dead. C-Deck, I have seen this from this team more often than I think other teams would care to admit. Farming from distance here on a Zeus to the south side of the map, and they're going to get eyes on Envy. They also see Big Daddy No-Tail rotating through. They've got someone on the high ground here. That's the Darkseer, but they're going to need a bit more to make the move in, and this is a tough go. They need to find Big Daddy if they want to make it happen. Can they chain stun him down? Big Daddy looking for the relocate. It got interrupted by Shrugatoss, I believe, and now Big Daddy, no, he didn't even get it off. Ends up going down. Envy forced out of the fight. A one for one so far. Support for support, but now the dust on the Garter, and he too will be forced back. Aggressive, just lucky to get out of here. Take a pounding from that nuke damage. Aggressive here. They've got a Sentry Ward up in the jungle. I think they may have seen this Bounty Hunter moving through. Garter, he's close, and he will be scouted out here. Now the tether forward. Do they have any detection? You betcha. Dust pop. Cloud9 just at the last few seconds of that Sentry's expiration date. Not quite there yet. Roche looks like he will fall before Cloud9 get in range, and there's no objectives to be obtained. They've even got running
the Bounty
down,
to scout this one out. They're trying to make their way in. Roche about to drop, and he will fall in the end. They're not quite in vision just yet to make a fight happen. Cloud9 hanging back for the time being. It's aggressive, surging forward, looking for openings onto Fada. He will go. Big Daddy doesn't have a relocate. No way to bail Fada out if he gets bursted down here, but he throws out the lightning bolt, and he will end up getting nearly the Bounty Hunter killed off. They're able to pop the mech, keep him alive. So it is a track kill going the way of C-Deck, plus an Aegis. High ground, they're in position to potentially turn this in a big way, and it is Garter who comes in first.
They're baiting Envy right now.
Merging Envy. They do have a relocate available. Cooldown comes through. The Zeus ult deployed. It's a lot of AoE damage. CDEC need to back off for now. XE going in. He went for the back in the wall. He hardly hit a thing. They've already lost their Aegis. Mech will come out a bit too late to save the Phantom Lancer on his first light, but Cheeky looking to make it work regardless. They have a Laguna at the ready. Yules interrupting the tether and holding Big Daddy in position. They will find the first real kill of this fight, and it's a 5-hero track kill for CDEC. Cloud9 thought they could take it. Doppelganger down. Misery.
Oh, he's going so far.
Purge. Aggressive going ham. And in the paint, he will find another kill. Fada can't even engage into this. But they do want to fight this one. It feels like Garter's in position. They're going to duel him off the bat. Envy committing for this. They want that duel damage, and Garter will drop. That's winner number two for Bone 7. If you're steady and fighting, the Death Ward can also really punish you. So that's something to keep in mind here.
CDEC, they might not see this coming as Bone 7. He knows they're there.
They do pop the Zeus ult. Are they going to initiate him, Garter? They do. It's just a bounty hunter down. Immediately the Death Ward to counter initiate. And Aggressive runs right directly on top of this. That might have been a bit too far. The back wall tries to come out, but already they've lost the bounty. They're going to lose XE here as well to Envy. Maybe not. He jukes around the trees. He tries to surge away. He will end up surviving through the sheer armor that his hero currently has. So it's a one for one. And now with the BKBs down, the lances are going to start coming in. Bone 7 held in position, make it a two for one. CDEC continuing to press forward. Bottom lane is pushing, and they might go for that tower. Roshan has respawned, however. Not sure if CDEC are aware of that. Cheeky having a fish. Happens.
This is so huge.
They're going to wrap around. Zeus ult is not available currently. Fada going to be the first man caught out. They start with the Yule Scepter, but immediately the Blink Duel. It's going to prevent a Laguna play. Well played by Bone 7. Death Ward is sitting here over the top of the fight. It's aggressive. Fish is on the backside, but nobody has dropped yet for Cloud9.
Aggressive slow.
Aggressive in a bit of danger. He's going to run back in the middle. Doppelganger to the right, but the wall's doing work, forcing C9 back. They do lose the Legion Commander. Garter on the way out. Everybody low now, and CDEC's blown their entire combination of spells.
He's waiting for that heal on that heart, and he's just going to continue to extend this fight right now. One more lance is going to go down.
And Cheeky's back. Cheeky has the Laguna Blade. Just doesn't even hesitate. Straight through the heart there of Big Daddy, and they'll press him back with a Darkseer Illusion of all things.
Cheeky, he's surged up.
C9. They're going for the plays here. Yules, follow-up stun available. There's no Wisp save. No, actually doesn't drop the stun. Instead, they go in with Aggressive, and they will maul Eternal Envy, surround him and bring him down. It's four dead as they also manage to clip Misery on the Skywrath Mage. CDEC.
With that heart, the Manta at this point is perfectly fine, and if anything, it just destroys C9 lineup because they're going to Eternal Envy.
But this time, there is a lot of backup. Big Daddy's in the position, and oh, there's the track immediately. Out comes the nuke from the Legion Commander. Do they look to chase? You betcha. Yules to start, stun to follow. Big Daddy, don't even need the Laguna for that. That's an easy takedown for Cheeky. And it feels like this is becoming the real issue.
He knows that Misery's there.
Looking for Misery. Oh, he doesn't guess the right way. Good force by Misery. Will back himself out. To the top lane goes the Turtle Envy. It's the Gyrocopter in front once more. He's going to press in the lane a bit. CDEC on the smoke. They're moving towards top. They want to try to make a backstab happen. Will Cloud9 realize in time? They're expecting the pressure to come bottom. They did show the Phantom Lancer.
Oh, I don't think they're reading this right. Here.
Uh-oh. Cheeky charges in first. He's going to find Eternal Envy off the bat. There's the Sun Laguna Blade. Where's that relocate? He can't even get there in time, and now they're going to lose the Io as well.
Oh, this is going to be another track kill guaranteed.
Oh, goodness. And that's a 5-hero track takedown. Big Daddy.
No Tail is so scared.
Gold, and he's, well, so dead. Track and nowhere to go. Big Daddy bites the dust.
C9 are going to struggle to defend this as they don't have their Gyrocopter up. He doesn't have buyback. He just bought his MKB.
Oh no, I don't know if CDEC know it, but they're probably finding out now. They make the go in Bada. He's trapped out, pushed away, and will end up falling. Again, the Wrath of Lina working its magic. This hero was an absolute menace in the group stage for CDEC, and Cheeky shows why here again in game number two. Laying into the melee racks, they'll bring that down. They rotate onto the bottom lane. CDEC, a wild card team, are just inches away, heartbeats away from potentially taking home $1 million.
They finally get the duel on Aggressive.
They get the duel on Aggressive. They try to make the move in. Can they bring him down? They do. Big fight for Cloud9 to hold that one. Immediate buyback from the Zeus. Two buybacks from CDEC. They want to fight this. They know the duel's on cooldown. They've already taken one lane of racks. They're just going to go for more here. They bring the Phantom Lancer right back in. And Cloud9 are out of plan Bs. They got to fight this one out.
Oh, here we go.
The wall. They found every single hero. Cloud9 get absolutely slaughtered. And they're looking for more. Misery next. It's GG. CDEC have done the unthinkable. This team goes from wild card contender to guaranteed top six and guaranteed well over $1 million at the International 2015.